Today we're talking about the growing gaming industry and specifically Corsair Gaming, a stock that I believe is a good way to play the industry as a whole. And what's great about investing in the gaming industry is over the years, it has seen a lot of growth and it's expected to continue to see growth. And that's around 12.9% compound annual growth rate from 2020 to 2027. If you guys haven't noticed, I'm kind of a nerd myself, and I personally have been gaming my entire life. So I am slightly biased because I do believe that the industry as a whole will continue to grow, and there'll be a shift over time where I'm seeing a lot of younger kids growing up with gaming in their lives. And as they get into adult age, that's actually sticking with them. And that's kind of my first generation, they're the millennial generation, where we grew up with gaming. There was a lot of bonding around that. So I believe that trend will continue and actually grow even faster than expected. Back to Corsair Gaming, which is trading at $38 per share with a market cap of $3.5 billion. They are a play on the computer hardware space within the gaming industry, and they're seeing a massive surge in growth. This is the Corsair website, and they sell everything from gaming gear all the way through gaming PCs. They have a wide range of products, and they're known to be on the higher end within the industry. If you're wondering why you haven't seen this company trade a lot on the public stock market, that's because it's a relatively new stock. They filed a Form S-1 in August, and they went public in September. Within that form, you can find prior year financial statements where you can see they grew revenue from $510 million all the way to $1.1 billion by the end of 2019.
So you're probably curious to see how are they doing in 2020 and where they expected to end the year.
Well, if we go to their investor relations website and go to the quarterly results for quarter three, we can see where they're expecting to land for 2020. According to the company's financial outlook, they expect to land around $1.6 billion, which represents a 47% year-over-year net revenue growth. And what's great to see about this company is not only are they growing their top line revenue, they're also increasing their margins. So going from 20.4% gross margins in 2019 to 26% in the trailing 12 months. And the company has called out the importance of streaming as well as esports as a huge growth component. So as websites like Twitch.com continue to grow and get a bigger user base, that also helps companies like Corsair Gaming.
So you're telling me growing industry, expanding margins, and a surge in revenue growth? Sounds like a winner. But let's take a step back and look at the valuation compared to those metrics to see, is the stock itself still a good buy? Is it fairly valued, undervalued, overvalued? And how does it compare to its competitors as well?
If we take a look at revenue multiples by sector, Corsair Gaming falls within the computers and peripherals industry. So a price to sales ratio of 4.83 and a EV to sales ratio of 5.14 is the industry average. When we compare Corsair Gaming to the industry, we can see that the price to sales ratio as well as the EV to sales ratio is better. But when it comes to the profitability margins, they are worse, which makes sense for a growing company not to have those higher margins when it comes to profitability as they grow. Now, one rule I use for investing in growth companies is the Rule 40, which looks at, does the growth rate plus the profit margin, is that higher than 40%? So with Corsair Gaming, they are over that 40% threshold. Therefore, I deem it okay when it comes to lower profit margins for now. And if we take a look at a company like Logitech, which is very comparable to Corsair Gaming in what they sell, we can get an idea of how Logitech is valued and see how does that compare to Corsair Gaming when it comes to financial metrics as well as multiples. When we take a look at the revenue multiples for Logitech, we can see that it is trading at a premium compared to Corsair Gaming, even though the revenue growth for both companies are comparable. Now, on top of the revenue multiple, I did a discounted cash flow model to determine what would be the intrinsic value of the company. Using a 25% growth rate for revenue over the next 5 years and a weighted average cost of capital of 7.12%, and with similar margins and capital spending as the assumptions. Now, with those assumptions, I calculated around a $43 intrinsic value for the stock, whereas right now it's trading around $38.
When I take all the factors that I know for Corsair Gaming and compare it to its competitors, as well as what I believe it could be valued based on an intrinsic value, Corsair Gaming as a whole looks pretty fairly valued. So it's not a crazy bargain, but it's a fairly priced business that I'm going to be personally buying a percentage, within my portfolio. It's a mid-cap stock that can have higher growth potential in a growing industry. So definitely interested in the company, and I will be adding to my public portfolio Corsair Gaming around these prices. If you did want to see the full analysis, you can check it out on my Patreon. Hope you guys enjoyed this video and you learned something. If you did learn something and you enjoyed it, please consider giving this video a thumbs up and subscribing to Main Street Wolf. As always, thanks guys for watching and have a great day.